Hello, this is Julie with Banger. Today we are talking about voiding payments in accounts payable. You can void payments made by check or credit card or made electronically. Appropriate reversing entries are sent to all interfacing applications. In accounts payable, go to the task menu and void payments. You can select from three payment types, a check, electronic payment, or a credit card. What you choose here determines what's available in the next field. If you have multiple bank accounts, you will have a selection of bank accounts here to choose from. If you are voiding a credit card payment, you need to select the credit card and the reference number of that payment. To select the check, you can either select from the list or you can simply type in the number of the check. It brings up all of the check information here. You can also view the invoices that it paid by clicking on the View Invoices tab. Only checks or electronic payments with the status of open in cash management can be voided. Payments with the status of cleared or reconciled are not available in the list of check or reference numbers when you click on list. Only credit card payments that have been included on an invoice for the credit card issuer can be voided. When you enter or select a credit card transaction that has been reconciled with a credit card statement, you will receive a warning. If you void that credit card transaction, it is removed from the Verify Statement Balance window. Choosing the accounting date, you need to consider how you want this to act in the corresponding applications. If you use the original date, it will take the original date of the check, 4/25 of 2015, and that will be the date on your reversing entries. So in general ledger, it will reverse at 4/25. In job cost, it will reverse at 4/25. If you choose to use a specific date, say I use 5/5 of 2015, it now will use this as the accounting date for the reversal in accounts payable, general ledger, and job cost. If you choose to restore the open invoice, it restores the invoices that were paid by the payment. If you clear this checkbox and an invoice was partially paid by the item, it will not be deleted, but the amount paid on the invoice will be reduced by the amount paid by this item. Invoices that were fully paid by the item will be deleted. You can view invoices by clicking on the View Invoices button. And you say okay, and it will give you a verification screen if this is the correct. The payment date was 4/25. I'm voiding it in May. Say yes. And it's asking me if I want to include these invoices for payment right away. So that would bring it right up on your invoices selected for payment screen. I'm not going to right now. Say okay and finish. And that's it. That's how you void payments in Sage 300. If you have any questions, you can reach me at coordinator@bangerinc.com, 1-800-458-7369. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and like this video. Have a great day.